Everybody has faced a decision in life that years later begs us to ask, what if? We usually don't get to answer that question with any amount of satisfaction. Today, I'm going to try. I've got a substituting gig at my old high school, and I'm going to take the opportunity to do a little Q&A with my past. I'll let you know how it goes.
Okay, everybody, come on in and have a seat. I don't know where you sit. There's nothing assigned in here. I'm Mr. Bender. I'll be filling in for Mr. Doherty. He decided to take his vacation early. So Big John got the call for the big dance. I'll be your teacher. Let's get going with today's lesson, huh? Okay, Mr. Doherty has the Wright brothers as today's lesson plan. So if you would, please get out a paper, a pen or pencil, crayon, something to write with. I'm going to give you five things. I want you to write them down, and then we'll be pretty much done. Number one, Orville Wright. You can abbreviate that W if you want. It's going to be about the Wright brothers. Number two is Wilbur. W. It's Wright.
Et ceci est-il de la classe française? Je ne pense pas qu'il a un indice.
Ne prenez pas la peine de lui dire.
Kitty Hawk. That's a place. They flew their airplane there. Number four. Bicycle shop. Eh? You getting this? Number five. Write down Orville again. These are the only possible five answers that you're going to have for any kind of quiz. And whereas the school year is basically over, you're not going to be getting a quiz. So just take these and put them in your folder. Keep them. Try and remember them. If you fail the quiz, I gave you the answers beforehand, didn't I? Looks like we've got some time left, so why don't we talk about another famous airplane, the Jefferson airplane. So let's get this crap off the board here and get your pencil and paper back out again. We got some writing to do. I started my search into the great past at the library. It's easy to guess how some decisions work out. There just isn't any question. For instance, I chose not to hang out with Andy Roberts. He was probably a perfectly nice guy and all, but by the 8th grade, me and Andy just weren't into the same things. I have no doubt where that would have ended up. Not a good scene. I did, however, choose to hang out with a guy named Ed Banky. Finger cuffs, everybody called him. Or Ed Stanky Banky, or my favorite, Skanky Ed Banky. Nice guy. He owns a hot dog stand now. My question is this. What would have happened if I had asked this girl out, Anna Moss?
Man, she was way out of my league and I knew it, but I never even asked. Instead, she went with this guy, Derek Peterson. All-around good guy and great on a pair of roller skates. I almost did ask her. Problem was, it was the weekend, and by the time Monday rolled around, it was too late. The courage left. How would my life be different if I had worked up the courage? Even if she said no, at least I'd know. But I didn't, and I don't. It only seems like yesterday that I sat against the wall and watched. It's as vivid to me today as it's ever been. He was wearing pants, I guess. She looked so amazing. I remember that she wore a green dress. Maybe it was white. Whatever they wore, I remember they looked so happy. That's a fair statement. They both looked happy. You know, she didn't go with him instead of me. She went with him rather than me because I didn't ask. For me to question my lack of decision 18 years ago is pretty lame. I'm happy with the way things turned out, and I don't think that one evening would have changed all that much. So I guess what it all boils down to is that while I may have missed out on something then, I can only use that as a guidepost for whatever else is to come.
It's just imagination.